Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's take a look at the basics of using the Apple Watch. Let's take a look at all the different ways you can interact with your Apple Watch. When you raise it up, you should see the home screen, which is the watch face. And you've got some physical switches on the side and also, of course, a touch screen. So the physical switches, you press in the crown and it kind of acts like a home button. It always takes you to the watch face. You can also turn the crown. It doesn't do anything here on the watch face, but we'll see it do something on other screens. You have this side button here. If you press the side button from the watch face, it takes you to your favorite contacts, and you can initiate messaging or a phone call from your iPhone, that kind of thing. You've also have the ability to swipe, so you can swipe down and go to your notifications, or you can swipe up and go to glances, and you can see all those dots at the bottom of the screen. They're all your different glance screens, and this one's the weather one. There's calendar, activities, power. You can go all the way to the left, and there's kind of a control center type of thing there where you can set it to airplane mode, you can mute it, things like that. So you can go back and forth between all these glance screens here by swiping. Pressing the crown, like I said before, acts like the home button, so it takes you back home very quickly and easily. Another thing that you can do is you can tap and kind of forcefully press. It's called a force touch, and it brings up a control mode for whatever it is you're using. So for the watch face here, I can change the watch face or customize there and click the crown to go back. So when I'm at the watch face there, I can click in the crown again and it takes me to the app screen. And then I can go and use a drag with my finger to get to whatever app it is I want to use. So let's, for instance, go into an app here. Let's pick, say, the stocks app. And then here I can scroll by dragging, or I can use the crown to scroll. Another control is, of course, to use Siri. And the way you get to Siri is the same way you do on, say, an iPhone. You press the home button. In this case, it's the crown, and you hold it in, and Siri will appear. And you can ask Siri a question, and Siri will try to figure out what you want. Now, when you need to enter text, you're going to have to do it with your voice. So, for instance, let's go into the Twitter app and say I want to create a new tweet. The way to do that is to do the force touch. It brings up a single control in the middle of the screen, that is to tweet. And that will then allow me to enter a new tweet. And the way to do that is to tap the microphone and then talk. I'm tweeting from my Apple Watch. I tap the done there and it will put it up there for me to inspect, and I can cancel or send the tweet. And this happens with anything you need to do to enter text in, whether it's messaging or perhaps interacting with an app that asks you to name something or enter some text in. You're going to have to do it with your voice. There's never a keyboard to enter something in. Now, controlling your Apple Watch is also dependent on your iPhone and that Apple Watch app. So you go in here, and this is where you can set things that you can't set on the watch. Like, for instance, I can go into glances and you can see there are the glance screens I was looking at. I can grab the right side and change the order. I can remove one. I can add them from the bottom. These are apps that I have that have a glance screen component to them. So that's how I would change what I see when I go to glances. Likewise, I can go to specific apps and change something. So for instance, if I go to weather, I can't change which cities are in my weather app there on the Apple Watch because they're just the same cities that are in the weather app on the iPhone. So I would go into my iPhone's weather app, change the cities there, and that's what I would see on my watch as well. But I can do something like, say, change the default city that appears when I first bring up the weather app. So there's a varying amount of controls that you can have, and it all depends on the app. And you've got the default Apple apps here, but you also have third-party apps as well that'll get added as you install apps. If you install an app on your iPhone that has an Apple Watch component to it, then it appears on your Apple Watch. If it doesn't have an Apple Watch component, there's nothing you can do to bring it on your Apple Watch. The developer has to add that to the app in order for it to appear on the Apple Watch.
The iPhone app is also where you control app layout. So you can see all the different apps you have installed, and this is how you drag them around to put them somewhere else. So you can kind of group your apps together just by kind of playing around with this interface.